My Three Doors Down song next on Music Surgery with Dr. Bob. Welcome to Music Surgery with Dr. Bob, where we cut into all kinds of musical topics, we diagnose them, we remedy them, and we stitch them back up. This week, I go into detail about what it was like to prepare for and write with the band Three Doors Down. Sumner, you idiot, that's 3 days grace. No, that's Three Dog Night. Sumner, that's Third Eye Blind. Now that's 311. There you go, funny guy. Let's get out the scalpel and go to work on it. Man, I've always loved this one. Every Time You Go by Three Doors Down peaked at number 5 and is an incredible memory, one that I'm proud to be a part of. I always thought this band sounded great on the radio, and I've always loved Brad Arnold's voice. And to hear him sing a song that I was involved in was a thrill. So let's get into how it all started. My publisher got a call that Three Doors Down had been working on a new record and felt they needed a few more songs that sounded like the radio and wanted me to fly out to Los Angeles from Nashville and see what we could come up with. Of course, my publisher was thrilled and I was too, so they set the date for 2 weeks away. Knowing I had 2 weeks gave me time to think about my approach and how to prepare. So let me get into this process because I think it's vital for success. The great quarterback Peyton Manning always said, "I may not be able to outpass you, but I can outprepare you." This always stuck with me. This guy was figuring out how to beat you weeks before you even hit the field, and I always thought, if this is Peyton Manning's work ethic, how could mine be any less? So the first step was to get in contact with the producer Howard Benson and the A&R person at the label to figure out what they really needed. I knew from before that if someone says they need a song that sounds like the radio, I have to find out exactly what that means. I don't want to go into a session having prepared a really great idea that's a slow song, and once I play it for the artist, they say, "Hey, that sounds really great, but we've already got 2 slow songs in the record we don't need anymore." After the conversations and hearing some of the other songs they'd referenced, I knew that they were looking for a mid-tempo rock song that was very melodic. So the way that I approach a write like this is to immerse myself in the singer's voice, listening to them sing over and over. So I put a playlist on of Three Doors Down, and that's all I listened to for 2 days straight. By the end of day 2, I could hear him singing in my head any melody I could come up with, and I had figured out the tonality of his voice, and I'd figured out where the sweet spots in his range were. If I come in and start singing a song idea to a band that's way too high for the singer, of course we could drop the key, but why even go through this step? Hit them right off with something that works. So for 2 or 3 days, with Brad's voice singing in my head, I just started thinking of great melodies and singing them into my iPhone. The next step was listening back to all these melodies and stitching together pieces of all of them to come up with what I thought was a great melody.
Every time you go, you take a part of me, a part of me with you. Every time you go, I feel it in my soul.
Next, I got a drum groove going to the beat of the melody, and here's that. Next, I experimented with chord changes under the melody until I found the best one that I thought supported it. Here are 2 that weren't quite right, and then the 3rd that I thought felt the best. Then it was time to put a track together that I could present my idea with. Sounds like a lot of work, right? But when your publisher is paying thousands of dollars to send you across the country and put you up in a nice hotel and write a song with a hit artist, this is what you do. You don't go in and depend on luck or a vibe. You come in like Peyton Manning, who already knows your defense before you run out onto the field. So with laptop and backpack, I flew to LA, hoping for the best. I wasn't guaranteed a win, just like Peyton Manning is it, but I felt that I prepared as best I could. We met at Bay 7 Studio and sat around and talked about music and fishing. Brad even gave me a great tip about casting that his grandfather had given him, so thanks, Brad, I'm much more accurate now. After the hellos and nice to meet yous, the elephant in the room is always, okay, what are we going to do here? So I opened up my laptop, plugged in my sound card to the speakers in the control room, and said, hey guys, I've been working on a little something. Let's see if it's something you want to vibe on. The moment of truth. I played the first verse and chorus and stopped after that to see what they thought. As soon as I hit stop, they said, dude, we love it. Immediately, my preparation had served me well and we were off to the races. In 20 minutes, we had finished writing the song and I played the track in the control room with Brad singing over the top, which sounded unbelievable. Just to record it on an iPhone so we had a good work tape of it. I gave a copy of the track to Brad, who said he was going to take it to his apartment where they were staying and would record the vocal and send it back to me so I could put it in with the track and make a good mix of the demo to send to Howard Benson and the label. The entire experience lasted an hour and 12 minutes. I got into my car, called my publisher, and the first thing he said was, oh no, what happened? Is everything okay? I laughed and told him how great it went, and they would have a great demo by the end of the day. I left the studio, went and ate at my favorite Thai restaurant on Ventura Boulevard, and by the time I got back to the hotel, Brad had sent me his vocal track. Oh my God, it sounded like Three Doors Down. Here's a clip of the demo that I mixed that day, and also a clip of the version that ended up on the album, mixed by the great CLA. Special thanks to my publishers at the time, Barry Coburn, Jewel Coburn, and Patrick Clifford. Also to Howard Benson, CLA, and the band Three Doors Down for giving me a memory that was one for the books. At the end of every episode, we have a segment called Hidden Gems, where we tell you about a singer, a song, an artist, etc. that you may or may not know about. This week's Hidden Gem is a production technique that I use for drums that brings out a beautiful low end in the drum set. I don't endorse any products on this channel, and I use all kinds of great plugins for drums, but this is something that I stumbled on with Easy Drummer by TuneTrack that is super simple and super easy. First, I record my live drums. And then I create MIDI notes from those drums to trigger samples. Once I've done that, I open an instance of Easy Drummer and I use this particular drum set. It doesn't come with Easy Drummer, but it's an add-on pack by famous mixer Randy Staub called Rock Solid Drums. Now this sounds so good, it's almost like cheating, but listen to the low end on this particular add-on pack mixed in with the live drums. I'm not adding any low end, any EQ, or compression. Boom, there you go. It's not as much a technique as it is a happy accident that I stumbled across one day while mixing, but we'll take any happy accidents that are given to us, right? Anyway, if you don't have Easy Drummer, it's a good one. And if you don't have this add-on pack, get it and pop it under your drums for some more low end and punch. You'll be surprised what it does for your mix. A true hidden gem. Hey, I know you all probably get tired of hearing this on YouTube, and I didn't even realize what it meant before I had my own YouTube channel. But please hit the subscribe button below. It helps me out, and it helps you to know when a new surgery is available to watch. It's free, and it's free. Wait, what? Well, that about does it. I think we've successfully cut into, diagnosed, and remedied the song Every Time You Go by Three Doors Down, and what it takes to prepare for a big right. Thanks for watching Music Surgery with Dr. Bob, and I'll see you the next time the doctor's in. Every time.